Hi there, Steve Walker again, founder of Ahoy-Boats, where I help to teach people who want to take up rowing about boats and about rowing. First of all, let me thank you for sticking with me and listening to me so far. I've had a lot of feedback from people who've been following the videos and also from customers who've been watching them as well. In fact, I had one yesterday morning. Let me just read it to you. Steve, good stuff. This is just to say that I'm hooked and have been since I got my skiff in August last year. I row virtually every day on my lock and on a few miles of the River Spey, just 10 minutes walk through the woods from my house. In winter, I'm the only boat in sight and I relish the fresh air and exercise in stunning scenery and wildlife. I pass an osprey nest every day. If any prospective purchaser of a skiff wants to try one, I'd be delighted to show it off and to talk on the phone. Best wishes, Peter Mackay. And this is the owner of a Turbo 2 Classic. And this is the sort of feedback I'm getting all the time. People are thrilled with rowing and with boats. You can do this. Let's go back to the benefits of rowing. You're out in the open, fresh air, communing with nature. You get a whole body exercise. It exercises every part of your body. Double the benefit to your heart of endurance or sprinting, because you have this power phase followed by the recovery phase. So it has twice the benefit of the heart. You not only get a bigger heart, a higher stroke volume, but also a thicker heart wall. So your heart's resilience and its ability to survive a heart attack, for example, would be greater. A rower's heart is stronger. That's the second benefit. The bond created by rowing in the same boat as somebody else. That's the third benefit. The pleasure of learning a new skill is the fourth benefit. And the fifth benefit of rowing is the glide in between the strokes. Then there is the sixth benefit, the extra bonus, which I forgot to mention, and that's the rest that you get for your mind. Because rowing is such a preoccupying and quite difficult thing to do, that you can't really think of anything else. Now I want to talk a bit about the different boats. But before I do that, I'd like to make you a guarantee. The guarantee is in two parts, because there's the part you would expect and then the part that you wouldn't expect. And the part you would expect is that the boats are guaranteed for 2 years against defects in manufacturing. A normal guarantee that you would expect from anybody, and we provide that warranty. But I also guarantee that you will be satisfied, not satisfied, thrilled with your new boat. And if you're not thrilled with it, then, and you bring it back to me within 30 days, then I'll give you your money back. These boats are excellent. But of course, I want you to make the right choice. There's quite a wide variety of different types of boat, and you need to make the right choice for your circumstances. You can always talk to me about this. My phone number is on every email that you get. But let me explain. Let's start with the Yole Club. Now, this is a very popular boat with institutions like the Sea Cadets, where the boat is going to get a lot of use by kids who may be not the most careful with them. They might be putting them on the sea in rough water, and they're virtually indestructible. They're also cheap, of course, compared to the other yachts, which I'll talk about in a moment. And I've sold an awful lot of these boats, and they hold their price really well, especially if you look after them. I've actually had one customer say that this was the best investment he ever made, because he actually sold it for more than he bought it. So it's costing you virtually nothing to enjoy rowing. The Yule Custom is a fiberglass boat, and as such it is much lighter than the polyethylene boats. Fiberglass is not as resilient and not as robust as polyethylene is, but it is a lot lighter. It is quite thin and brittle and therefore more susceptible to damage. If you were to be in a sort of situation where you are likely to be bumping into sharp rocks, things like that, then you might get a ding which would need a repair, where a polyethylene boat would just bounce off it. So that's the difference, and the customization of a Yule Custom is the colour of it. You can have it in British Racing Green, which is very popular in places like Henley-on-Thames, the Ferrari Red, which would be very popular and is popular in Wales. And then there's a lovely blue colour, I call it Mediterranean blue, and all these boats have a white deck, and the blue one is very popular. You could also have the boat in white, and if you have it without the name down the side, which you get with a customised boat, with a custom you have whatever name you choose, your wife's name or your girlfriend's name or your own name or a club's name or whatever can be put down the side of the boat. With a Yule Class, which is white, then you don't get that. That's not included in the price. And both of these boats appeal to the professional people, people who are successful business people. Maybe if you bought yourself a nice property on the riverside with where the garden runs down to the water, or lakeside or seaside, then investing in a Yule Custom is a small extra amount to pay to be able to take advantage of this waterside property. The Yule Class would be bought by somebody who is perhaps doesn't feel like they need to be flashy, or they don't want to have the name down, they just want a good boat but at a reasonable price. So the more prudent customer would perhaps go for that. So those boats, the fiberglass ones, they will tend not to be going to clubs or sea cadets or sea scouts or outdoor pursuit centres. That's why the Yule Club is called a Yule Club. And people who would buy the Yule Custom would be people who want the best and get the best of everything. And here's another boat that I haven't mentioned before. It's called the Yule 16 WV, and it's named after its designer, who was a French sailor, a successful French sailor, who wanted to encourage open water rowing in the 1980s. And so he designed this boat, and it's beautiful lines, quite different from the Yule, which came out in 1993. The Yule, 6,000 of them have been sold. This boat was made in a different place by a different manufacturer. They sold about 800 of them, and then they stopped making them. And Vera's Boats have managed to get hold of the mould, and they are now making these lovely boats. They've got beautiful traditional lines. I tend to think of a boat built in the 1980s as being quite modern, but the Yule was designed in 1993, and that's now become a traditional boat. Well, not a traditional, it's become a classic in its own time. This new boat, the Yule 16 WV, can be used as a double, provided you don't use sliding seats. And if you want to have a sliding seat, then you can use it as a single. And you can take a passenger in it. And it has the advantage over the Yule of not having an open aft. The open aft in the Yule is for self-bailing, so it's great on the sea. But if you are going to take a young toddler with you, a child, you might feel concerned about the risk of them falling out of the back. So a boat that does have a transom at the back is more protected, if you like, for a toddler, for a young child. So that's a very attractive looking boat of a traditional design. Now let's look at the Turbo 2. This is the boat that I was first attracted to when I went to Châtelain. If you remember, I said that I could stand up in the boat, and even without oars, I didn't fall in. And this is a go-anywhere boat. You see me row over the weir in Chester in it. And it's very popular around the clubs all around the country. And it has been largely superseded now by the TS515 training school, which I'll talk about in a moment. But it's still popular in situations where you would be on the coast. Then the Turbo 2 has the edge on the TS515 because of its extra volume. I've rowed Falmouth Harbour in one, and I saw this great big wave coming towards me made by the St. Moore's ferry. And I thought, oh my God, I was quite intimidated by this wave because I've been used to sculling in a fine boat. And yet the turbo just popped over it, no problem. Didn't feel any balance issues, and it didn't get any water in the boat. And I thought, oh, this is what this boat is for. The Turbo 2 Classic was fitted with a sliding seat, which is what the rowing clubs wanted in order to teach people to row, because rowing clubs have to use sliding seats and not sliding riggers. I'll talk about that again in a moment. Now, the TS515 that has been introduced about 5 years ago to this country, and it's an Australian built boat, unbelievably popular over there, and now it's becoming unbelievably popular over here. I've just had a big order for 64 of them, which I'm very pleased about. It's a boat designed by a man who clearly knows a lot about rowing and engineering. He was a very accomplished rower and sculler in his day, Ken Edwards, and he's clearly a very good engineer as well, because to me it feels a very comfortable boat. It fits the body really well. Everything is at the right angle and the right height relative to other things in the boat. It's well set up. But the best thing about it is that it's got stabilisers on the outriggers. And these stabilisers are detachable. So you can learn with the stabilisers on like you would if you were on a bike with stabiliser wheels. And then when you've got the hang of it, got the skill, mastered it, you can take them off. And you look to all the world just like a proper sculler. And this boat is made also of polyethylene, but it's different from the Yole and the Turbo range, insofar as it's made from a polyethylene foam sandwich. And to summarise the process, you put a lot of powder into a big oven that you heat up and rotates around, and the oven is in the shape of a boat. And the powder turns into a liquid and lines the inside of the mould with polyethylene, a thin film of it. And then you cool it down, and you put some more powder in, but this time with a foaming agent. And then you turn it, heat it up again, and spin it around. It's all computer controlled. And now you have quite a thick layer of polyethylene foam, which is closed cell foam. No, water wouldn't sort of penetrate it by capillary action like in blotting paper. If any water did get into it, it wouldn't go anywhere. And then you do the same as the first process. You just put in some polyethylene powder without a foaming agent and you line the inside. And then what you get out is a boat that's made of three layers: polyethylene, polyethylene foam, and then polyethylene again. And this is very stiff and very light. So you can get about three boats a day out of a process like this, but the investment initially is huge. So this is a very good boat to buy. It's lightweight, only weighs 20 kilograms even with a rig up, and I think it's a great boat in which to teach people to row. And it's much more popular on inland waters than the Turbo. It's as popular as the Turbo 2 Classic was when that came out, so it goes out to a lot of clubs. But a lot of private individuals also like this boat. And I've had customers who've written to me after they've received the boat and said, I went for a 10-kilometre row on my first outing. Or, it's the best day of my life. You know, everything that I ever expected. That sort of comment. They love it. So it's not just for clubs, it's for anybody. Now, going back to the Turbo 2, the Turbo 2 was designed as a boat that could have a sliding rigger or a sliding seat. And the sliding rigger was introduced, it was invented a long time ago, and it only really came to prominence in the 1980s. That was when Peter Michael Kolber won the world championships in a fine boat that had a sliding rigger fitted to it. And then the next year, everybody in the finals was using a boat with a sliding rigger. And the next year, FISA, the International Rowing Governing Body, they banned them. And they banned them because otherwise the whole of the world's fleet of rowing boats would have become obsolete overnight. But it wasn't banned for recreational rowing. Of course, you can do whatever you like. It's your choice to go rowing in a sliding rigger boat if you want, that's fine. And Noel Louvet, who was the founder of Vera's Boats, he worked out that this would be a good thing to do. There was a demand for slimmer boats rather than the Yole, which could carry two people, that was a dedicated single. And so he invented the Turbo Skiff. And the Turbo 2 was a polyethylene version of the Turbo Skiff. And the Turbo Skiff has the sliding rigger, and that's made of fiberglass. The Turbo 2 is made of polyethylene, so it's cheaper, and it's made in this rotor moulding process, but not the same process that the TS-515 is made from. The TS-515, by the way, that stands for TS, for training scale, and 515 because it's 5.15 metres long. So the Turbo 2 wing is not really a boat that is bought by rowing clubs. There is the odd one here and there. But mostly they're bought by private individuals who don't want or the Turbo Skiff, because maybe because they have a situation where their boat is more vulnerable to damage, and the Turbo Skiff would be a bit vulnerable because it's made of fiberglass, or because they just want to save money and they don't want the cheapest boat. But the Turbo 2 wing with the sliding rigger is a better choice for them, because the boat goes better with a turbo with a sliding rigger. And it's also better, especially if you are heavy, because your mass is moving forwards and backwards if you have a sliding seat, but your mass stays still in the boat if you've got a sliding rigger. That helps to stop the boat pitching, and it helps to stop the hull oscillating forwards and backwards, and so that generally speaking it reduces drag and makes the boat faster. So that's why the Turbo Skiff and the Turbo 2 wing have sliding riggers and go faster than the sliding seat boats. The Turbo Skiff, that comes in a range of colours which are very nice. There's a pearlescent blue, the hull is made of two halves that are glued together. You can also have it in Ferrari red, and it is the colour of a Ferrari, because I had a customer who had a Ferrari and he put it on top of his car and it was exactly the same colour. The boat's also available in white, and I have seen a yellow one. So, we've covered the Yole Club, which mainly goes to clubs and sea cadets and people like that, and the Yole Custom, which should be for the discerning customer, for people who want the best of the best. The Yole Class, which is white, with a slightly more prudent person. Then the Turbo 2 Classic, which has a sliding seat and is popular in rowing clubs, but now has been superseded by the TS-515, a training scull, which is a better boat for inland waters but not for coastal waters, where the Turbo 2 would still be better. And then there's the Turbo 2 Wing, which is a sliding rigger, a polyethylene boat, and the Turbo Skiff, which is a fiberglass boat. The Turbo 2 wing is only available in white polyethylene. The Turbo Skiff is available in various colours. Finally, there's a new boat by Vera's Boats called the Yolette. And this is a single. It has a sliding seat, a nice wooden Martinoli seat with nice silent running slides. And they think it is the best boat that they've ever built, the best boat they've built so far. It's very stable. It's more stable than a Turbo Skiff. And it's faster than a Turbo Skiff, even though it doesn't have a sliding rigger. But it's a bit longer, and it's a bit more expensive. But it's very light, and they've targeted this boat at women, because women find the Yole a bit of a struggle when they get ashore to lift it and, you know, manoeuvre with it, manhandle it ashore. And the Yolette is much lighter, and therefore is very attractive to women. But of course it's also attractive to men like me, who are lightweight. In fact, not just lightweights can use it. So I think it's going to be a very successful boat. But it's brand new. Maybe you are one of the sorts of people who might buy this boat. Now we come to the point where you actually have to choose which one of these boats you're going to buy. Is it going to be a Yole? If so, which sort of Yole? Are you responsible for lots of people? You know, young kids, whatever, or are you buying for yourself and your family? Is it just for you, or do you want to share the boat with somebody else and go rowing and sculling with them? Bear in mind that in a Yole, you can put a passenger seat, so you can have a Yole, somebody rowing and somebody sitting doing nothing. Take your animals with you, dog or whatever. They seem to like Yoles, I don't know why. Or are you wanting a boarding boat in which you can learn to scull and progress to be a good sculler of ultimately a fine boat. Now that might be in a club situation where you're learning amongst a lot of other people or teaching a lot of other people, or you might be just a private individual who wants to row on the River Dart or wherever. So, the other boats are the Turbo 2, if you're in a coastal situation, or the Turbo Skiff, again the coastal situation, and the Yolet, very good for either, and very stable. And there is one other boat which I haven't mentioned, and that is a very unusual boat. It's called a catamaran. Cat for a catamaran, and ram, which is French for rameur, which is a rower. Okay. And this is a boat with two hulls, and it has a sliding rigger, and it's very stable. It's faster than a yawl, but not quite as fast as a turbo skiff. It also has this unique feature that you can look down and see the water flowing underneath you and see through into the bottom of the river or the sea or whatever you're rowing over. So now you're fully briefed on all the different boats that I can supply. So what I'd like you to do now is to click on the Add to Cart button below and order the boat of your choice. And I'll get it to you within about 6 weeks. It's a bit of a movable feast because the boats have to be built. It depends what time of year you're ordering, whether I've just been and collected some boats or whether I'm just about to collect some boats, and whether we've got a container on its way from Australia or whether it's already arrived, whether, you know, there are lots of variables. But about 6 weeks is the normal waiting time. So click on the Add to Cart button below and place your order now. Go on, do it now. I'm waiting. I'm waiting for your order. Go on. Click the Add to Cart button. Make your choice. Do it now. There is no time to delay. Your life is ticking by and you need to get on and do this for your health, for your well-being, for your family, for yourself. Don't put it off. Your life could pass you by without you ever having bought a boat. So get on and do it now. I've just got back from sculling and I fully expected to see an order from you. Why haven't you pushed the button yet? Click the Add to Cart button. So what's your excuse? Don't tell me. You've got a bad back. I've got a bad back. I put it out this morning, I put it back this morning. If it's not right tomorrow, I'll go and see the chiropractor. Look at this guy. He's only got one leg and he cycles with his boat down to the water. And he goes out in weather like this. Look at this. He took these two photographs from the yawl that he's rowing in the winter. You've got to admire people like that, haven't you? Let me tell you a little story about a customer called Jürgen Duft. I got a phone call from his daughter saying, is there any way to convert a turbo so that you can row it with one hand? Well, you can't. And I asked why, and I was told that he'd had a stroke. Oh, right. Anyway, he got better. And he then exchanged his turbo for a training skull. And he's still sculling to this day. See, if you really enjoy sculling, you just have to do it. You can't be without a boat. And if something gets in your way and prevents you from sculling, you have to find a way around that obstacle. And so, what's your obstacle? Is it that you haven't got any money? Make some more money. Sell something. Borrow some money. You've got to have a boat. I'm trying to think of other reasons why you might not buy. Come on, click that Add to Cart button. Well, thank you for listening to me. Thank you for putting up with all my foibles and all my idiosyncrasies and all my enthusiasm. And it's been a lovely day today compared to the other days I've been making this recording. I've been out sculling on the river this morning, had a fantastic time, and I hope that you will be able to enjoy your boat on similar days. So this is Steve Walker of Ahoy-Boats signing off. Make that decision, click on the button below, and order your boat now.